So good morning everyone, we will just again look into this extracting connected components again. So in this we have already discussed that we have to use a structuring element B, which is an 8 connectivity structuring element, and this formula it is given, xk equals to xk minus 1 dilation of B intersection with A. Okay, so if you see over here, other structuring elements are also possible, like 4 connectivity structuring element, it is also possible over here. Okay, now what happens is that, say this is our image A. Now in this what we have to do is that we have to select any seed point. Okay, which is the seed point? Say this is the seed point we have selected, and we want to find out which regions are connected with this point when we use this 4 connectivity 8 connectivity picks this structuring element. Okay, now when you get this one over here, say this is the seed point, right? So what you do, you dilate it using the 8 connectivity this structuring element. So you get this thing. Then what we have, we have intersection with A. So basically we have to do multiplication with A. Intersection means multiplication with A. Okay, so you do the multiplication with A and you get x1. Okay, x of xk equals to xk minus 1 plus dilation of B intersection A. This whole process is xk, right? Now this xk minus 1 is basically our original image, which is equal to x0. Okay, so basically what we are doing, x1 equals to x0 dilation of B intersection of A, right? Now we have got this one. So see, this pixel, it is 0 over here. Now while we did the dilation, we get 1 over here. Now again when we did the intersection, we got this 0. Okay, similarly we will take this as the image for the next stage x1 and do the dilation again in the similar manner, and then multiplication with A to get x2. Okay, similarly in the next step we will take x2, dilate it, and then find out x3. Okay, in this way we will do this operation till two consecutive xk values, that means xk equals to xk minus 1. That means when two consecutive values of xn and xn minus 1 they become equal, we have to repeat this operation, and when it happens we end over there. That is our connected region. Okay, so how do you find out whether both are same or not? Basically you have to minus xk minus x of k minus 1. If you find this to be 0, you have to do it. That means you have reached a stage where both xk and xk minus 1 are same. Okay, now over here you will find that we can use either 4 connectivity structuring element or 8 connectivity structuring element. In the next example, which is the region filling, we only can use 4 connectivity pixel. Okay, so in the region filling, say this is the image and this is yellow marked ones, they are the region. So within this region, see, there is a what do you call it? A group of zeros. Okay, so basically these are called as holes. These are called as holes. Holes are any background pixels which are enclosed within a brighter pixel region. Okay, so they are called holes. Okay, So these are holes. So how to do that? Over here you have to find out xk equals to xk minus 1 dilation of b. Until this it is same with the extracting of the region, then intersection with a complement. Okay, intersection with a complement. Okay, so this is a, now we have to find a complement. So a complement is this one. It is nothing but in place of 1 you change it to 0 and 0 will be converted to 1. Then structuring element is this one. Then we have to do the dilation with b. So again we have to find a seed point. Now the seed point should be in the region of the hole. Okay, so over here we have got this seed point, this one as the seed point. Okay, then we have dilated, but see, we have not got any values in this region because we have used 4 connectivity pixels. Okay, then after this dilation you do intersection with AC, that means you do multiplication of BA with AC and you get the desired result for the x1. Okay, similarly take x1, do the dilation of x1 and then you multiply with a complement. See, there is a slight change in the pattern, and this pattern, then you use this one and then again do the dilation and again multiply it, and you will find that you have got this connected area. So see, x4 and x5, they are same again over here, right? Now if you compare this with this one, see, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So if you see over here, 1 2 1 2 3 4 5, right? So sorry, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, right? So the area which was we were having holes, they have been filled up. Now if we use 8 connectivity structuring element in this case, we have already seen in the numerical that we get out of this area, of the enclosed area. So we cannot use 8 structuring elements. The 4 point structuring element, it allows us to stay within the bounded region. Okay. Now thinning. Thinning is given by thin AB. It is given by A minus A Hilbert transform of B. Okay. So in this, the structuring elements are B1, see, 1, 1, 1, 1, XX, 0, 0. Okay. Then B2 is, you just rotate it by 1 pixel in a clockwise manner, you get B2. Similarly, you again move it 1 pixel in the clockwise manner, you get B3, B4, B5, B6, B7 and B8. Okay. Usually what happens, this is a very complex process. First you have to find out the Hilbert transform and then put minus, you minus the image or subtract the image from the A. But there is a easy operation which will make your life easy basically. So if there is, when you put this structuring element, if there is a complete match, you have to change the pixel, center pixel to 0, else pixel retains the same value as in the original image. Okay. Now first what we have to do is that we have to take this B1 structuring element, and suppose this is the original image, we will be creating a border, and using the border will be created by replication of the border pixel values. Okay. Now we will start fitting the central pixel of B1 this is the central pixel one over here, and then we will see whether there is any hit or miss. Okay, so in this case we find a hit at this location. So if you see 000, if you create a border over here with this will be 0, this will be 1, this will be 1, so 000, then don't care 1, then again don't care 111. Okay, so in this thing what happens is that if you find out the hit miss transform, then you again have to do the you have to subtract that hit miss transform from A. So to avoid these mathematical steps, what we do is that if there is a complete match, then we change the center pixel to 0. Otherwise, the pixel returns the same value as in the original image. Okay. So in this case, over here we have found a hit. So we change this pixel value to 0. Similarly, if you see at this location, we are having 000, don't care, 1, don't care, then 111. So again, there is another hit. So we will change it to 0. So there are not much hits over here. So next we go to the next step. Using this image, we will again try to do the thinning, and we will find that these two locations we will find the hit, and this process will continue until and unless we are able to do thinning for the further steps. Okay, now once this is done, then we have to create B2. Now is how this B2 is created. This B2 is created by moving this pixel cells one pixels in a counterclockwise manner. So this X, it comes to this position 1, this one moves to counterwise, this one again moves to counterwise, then this one again moves counterwise, this X moves counterwise, this 0 gets counterwise, and again in this fashion, if you see, we get B2. Similarly, if we again rotate these pixel values in a counterclockwise manner, we will get B3, and then using B3 we can get B4, B5, then using B4 we'll get B5, using B5 we'll get B6, using B6 we'll get B7, and again counterclockwise rotating the B7 pixel elements of the stretching elements, we will get B8. Okay, so then in the next step, what we will do, we will repeat the steps in the step 2 what we have done in the step 1, but this time with stretching element of B2. Over here we can see that there will be no change. Similarly, in the step 3 we will be doing the thinning using the B3 structuring element, there will be no change. While using in the step 4, while we are doing the thinning using the B4 structuring element, using this image, if you see, we have used this image over here since there was no changes in step 2 and step 3. So again, if we try to do the thinning, we will find 10 at this location and 10 at this location. Then using this thing, we will do the thinning using the structuring element B5 in the step 5, and we will find that again we are able to thin it, thin two pixel elements. Then using this, we will do the thinning in step 6 using B6 structuring element. Again, if you see, there are no changes over here. Then again we will repeat the step using B7 structuring element, there will be no change. And again using this image, since there were no changes, we are basically using this for step 8 where we will be using B8 structuring element, and here we will be getting 10. So this is the thinned image of the original image of which we started with. Now this thinning, it is basically sensitive to noises. If you see over here, we were having an isolated 0 within an area of 1s. So this may be considered as paper noise, and this has affected the output in this fashion. Now if that this 0 was not present, then the result would have been different. Okay, Now in thinning, what happens is that the thinning allows us to successively erode away foreground pixels. It preserves the endpoints of the line segments, and repeated thinning results in obtaining single pixel wide skeleton, so the center line of an object. Okay, so this is it in thinning. Our next topic is thickening. Thickening is given thick A comma B is A union of A hit me transform of A using the structuring element B. This process is similar to that of the thinning. Here also we use 8 structuring elements. Unlike in thinning, where the central pixel of the structuring element was 1, in thickening our central pixel is 0, and the rest of the values they are same. They are also B2 is made from B1 just by rotating this pixel element C. We have rotated this one like this in the clockwise manner, and our B2 structuring element is made, and likewise we make all the other structuring elements. Now the process is similar. The only thing is that if there is a complete match, then we have to change the central pixel to 1. Otherwise the pixel retains the same value as in the original image. Okay, so next is your convex hull operation. So what is a convex hull operation? It is the smallest polygon that contains all the points in a given image. Okay, so in this, 4 number of structuring elements are used. So what happens is that suppose you are having an image and say you are having this kind of thing. So this was supposed to be say closed one, but somehow you got some corrugation. Okay, so what the convex hull says is that it is the smallest number of polygon which can enclose whole of the object. Okay, so in doing so, what it does is that if there are some imperfections in the image which you are trying to analyze, it closes that down. Okay, so this is the main operation of the convex hull, and in this we use the structuring elements B1, B2, B3 and B4. So how it is done? Xk equals to xk minus 1 hit miss transform of B1 union of A. Okay, union of A. So I hope everyone should be able to do this operation, right? Hit miss transform we have already seen, and union of A is basically multiplication with this thing, with the original image. Okay, so what you have to do after finding all xik values, after finding all xik values, perform union of xik values. Okay, perform union of all xik values. Okay, to get the original thing. So what happens? You do, say you get xk1, xk2, xk3 and so on, whatever you get, then you do the union of all this to get a composite image, xk image, and then you go for the this B2 processing with the B2 structuring element and do all the things to get this all the xk I values, do the union, and then again go for the 3. So in this session it should be done. Okay. Extension to gray level images, we have already seen this statistical order. If there is any what is erosion, dilation, what is the opening, right, what is closing, so all of these are basically done with the operations with erosions and dilations, right? So you will have to work with this. So if you put this in the gray level image, then it will be working with the gray level images. Okay, where you have to do only the these things, only the operations which employs erosion and dilations, they can be extended to the gray level images, like opening, closing. There are some other operations which we did not cover, like proper opening and proper closing. Okay, thank you.